Okay, in this lecture I'm just going to show you that how you will conduct, how you will run a two-way ANOVA with replication or with interaction. So as in my previous lecture, I have already discussed in great detail that how you will conduct a two-way ANOVA without replication. Without replication means we don't want to do an interaction between two independent variables and their impact on the dependent variable, but we just directly, separately checking the effect of an independent variable on the dependent variable. One independent variable impact on the dependent variable, and in the next stage we conduct a second analysis for another independent variable on the dependent variable. So now in this one we will also discuss the interaction between these two independent variable and their impact on the dependent variable. So two-way ANOVA, which is also called a factorial experiment. Why it is called a factorial experiment? Because we will repeat the experiment for each and individual independent variable and its impact on the dependent variable. Replication means an independent repeat of each factor combination. We will check for each and every combination. The purpose of factorial experiment is to examine the effect of a factor A on the dependent variable Y. So we did this same in the two-way ANOVA without replication. The effect of factor B on the dependent variable Y along with, so these two are the same as we did in the two-way ANOVA without replication. The third property, the third analysis is totally different from without replication, and that is why due to this factor it is called two-way ANOVA with interaction or with replication, because we will repeat the process. The effect of the interaction between different level of the factor on the dependent variable. So we will check, we will repeat, we will conduct different experiment, and for those experiment we will repeat each factor combination. Interaction exists when the effect of level for one factor depends on which level of other factor is present. So you will understand from this very simple example. For example, the following data represent the result of three questions obtained by three students in three subjects. So now you can see the behavior of this is totally changed. You remember in my previous lecture in the two-way ANOVA without replication, there was an independent variable of breeds, and in the rows there was different rations. But now you can see that in the students, for the first student, these are different samples. So we took samples for one student, we took three different samples. So you can see that for student one, in English there are three different samples, in math there are three different samples, in statistic there are three different samples. Similarly, for the second student, we took already three different sample in English, three different sample in mathematics, and three different sample in statistics. Similarly, for the third student, we took the same. So now we want to check the student one interaction, because this is independent variable, this is independent variable, and the marks are dependent variable. So we want to check for different samples which we have collected so far. So perform the analysis of variance upon these data and test the hypothesis that the subject are of equal difficulty. So basically subject are mentioned in the column, so mean all the column mean are same. So this will be our first and null hypothesis, the subject are of equal difficulty. And the alternative of this one, the subject are of equal difficulty, so this is null hypothesis, and the alternative will be not all subject are of equal difficulty. Similarly, students mentioned in the rows, so the student have equalability, the student have equalability in all these courses, not all students have equalability. So this will be the alternative hypothesis. Now the third one, the third property which make it with reflection, which make it with interaction, that is this one, that the student and subject do not interact. So there is no interaction between student and subject. So now we also want to conduct the interaction between this independent variable and this independent variable. There is no interaction between student and subject. But in two-way ANOVA without replication, we ignore totally the interaction between students and subject. If they ask us to conduct a two-way ANOVA without replication, then the third one, we will totally ignore this. We will only check the subject with the dependent variable with marks and the student capability while getting these marks. So we will do this and the story will be finished. But now in this case, they also asking the student and subject do not interact. There is no interaction between student and subject. The interaction effect are not of equal to zero, are not same. So in order to conduct this, you need to understand. So what will be the sample size? So you can, how many observation are there? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, similarly 9, in this one 9. So 9, so there are 9 in this, 9 in this and 9 in this. So the total will be 27, because 3 students, and for every student they took a sample of 3. So 3 into 3 into 3, it will be 27. The second topic will be, the second process will be level of significance. So level of significance, let's suppose we want to conduct a level of significance, we want to use a 0.05%. Now we need to calculate total sum of square. So how we will calculate total sum of square? So it is also the similar one, the same. So how we will conduct this is now, because now we have three different, so that is why we are using summation I, summation j and summation k, x square ij and correction factor. So before going to calculate correction factor, the correction factor formula g square over n. So how we will calculate g square? So for g square, what should we need to do? You need to add this and take the first student marks average in English, first student marks average in mathematics, first student marks average in statistics. So when you calculate this, this is the average of the first. So 13 plus 18 plus 15 divided by 3, the average will be 46. Similarly, 23 plus 20 plus 16 divided by 3, the average will be 59. Okay. Similarly, for the first student average, 22 plus 23 plus 20 divided by 3, this will be 65. Similarly, you will calculate the average for the second student marks in English. So 21 plus 16 plus 24, average will be, so 21 plus 16 plus 24 divided by 3, it will be 61. 20 plus 14 plus 24 divided by 3, the average will be 58. And 20 plus 15 plus 22, so the second student average marks in statistics will be 57. Similarly, for the third student, you will calculate average. You will add all these and divide with 3. You will add all these and divide with 3. So you will get 45, 46 and 58. So now in order to calculate G, because in the 2-way ANOVA, we simply calculate G. But now in this one, we will take average, because there are different samples in each category. There are some sub factors. So what you will do, you will add this in order to calculate TJ. So 46 plus 61 plus 45, basically these are the different averages. So for these averages, we calculate the mean. Similarly, for maths, we calculate mean. For state, we calculate mean. When you add all this, you will get 495. Similarly, if you add 46 plus 59 plus 65, it will be 170. 61 plus 58 plus 57, it will be 176. 45, 46 and 58, it will be 149. So if you add this column, or if you add this row, this will be 495. So 495 square divided by 27, because we have total observation of 27. So this is our correction factor, 9075. And how we will get this? So you remember that taking square of this, this, this. So we just take square of this, 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 and we add this. So this is summation x square ij. Similarly, for maths, we need to take square of all these. We need to take square of all these in the statistic column. When you add this, when you add all these things, it will be equal to, it will be equal to 9403. 9403. When you add 2684 plus 3071 plus 3648, it will be 9403 minus correction factor. So we have already calculated correction factor. It will be 328. Now we want to calculate between subjects. So subjects are mentioned in the column. So between subject sum of square, the formula is summation. So J summation TJ square. Now you need to take the square of this, 152 square, 163 square, 180 square. Okay. And you need to add this. So this will be summation TJ square. Summation TJ square will be this plus this plus this. It is 82077. And RN, because how many rows and how many in each row? What is the sample? So we have three rows, and in each row we have three different samples. We took for every student, we have three students, and for every student we took a three sample. So 3 into 3 into 3. Okay. So basically we have three rows, and in each row we have sample of 3. So 3 3s are n is 3. 3 3s are 9. 9. So minus The correction factor, which we have already calculated, this is 44.22. Between students, now we did between subject, now we want to conduct between students. So the formula for student is, so we have already calculated R, for all this R sum, so this plus this plus this, this 61 plus 58 plus 57 this, then in the next column which will be called R square I, so 170 square plus 176 square plus 149 square, when you add all these, this is called summation R square I, so T square J sum and summation R square I sum will be same, so that is why I just write this summation T square J and summation R square I, which is 82077. So between student sum of square, we will put 8077 and column. So how many column you have? 3 column. Okay. And in every column, the number of students are 3. 3 different categories. So 3, 3 is 9. So we just write 9. When you deduct correction factor, so this will be 44.67. Okay. So this value will be same with this one. There is maybe a little bit error occurs. So 44 point, so doesn't matter because this is after the decimal, so don't worry about this. Now we want to calculate interaction sum of square, which is totally new now because we didn't do it before. Because now we want each student and its effect on the marks comparing the subject. So interaction sum of square, the formula summation x square ij. So how you will calculate this summation x square ij is totally different from this one, okay? Because we use this for this, and now we using interaction sum of square, which is summation I summation j x bar ij. So this is basically x bar. You not need to forget about this red line. So basically this is the average square. The average 46 came from where? 13 plus 18 plus 15 divided by 3. So it is 46. So basically this is the square of the mean. 61, which is the mean square, this one. 45, which is the mean, and the square of 45 is this one. When you add all this, you will get x1 bar. So if I just write this, it will be, this will be x1 bar square ij. Similarly, this one will be x bar, this basically 2ij. This is x bar 3ij. So when you add this, so that is why I just write summation I summation j x bar ij square, which is 2766. So I just write 276661. And how many categories, how many groups, how many different groups we have? So we have 3 different subjects and 3 different students. So we just divide with 3 minus summation tj square. So summation tj square is this one, which is 82077 divided by rn. Rn mean, because this is for, this is the summation tj square, this is for between subject. So we have 3 different subject and 3 in each subject, we have 3 different samples. So 3, 3 is 9. Similarly, this one, okay, which is summation r square icn, which we have already write at this place. Okay, so we just put it this plus cf. So now you need to add, okay, this is plus cf. Plus correction factor. So 56.44 is the interaction sum of square. Now error sum of square. So before we use total sum of square minus column sum of square minus row sum of square. But now we will also deduct the interaction sum of square. We denote this interaction sum of square with the SSCRC. So 3 to 8 minus. So now we want to put all these value which we have calculated so far. So basically from the error sum of square, this is the value. Now in the next step, we will construct an ANOVA table. So in ANOVA table, now we have different categories between subjects. So how many subjects we have? 3. 3 minus 1 degree of freedom will be 2. Between students, so how many students we took? We took 3. 3 minus 1 will be 2. Interaction, so C minus 1, R minus 1. So 2, 2 is a 4. And error within, so the error within formula is this one, RC. So 3 and C 3, rows 3, column 3, 3, 3 is a 9. And 9, n minus 1. So how many groups in this whole experiment? We have 3 different groups. 3 different students and 3 different subjects. So 3 minus 1. So 9 into 2 is 18. And the total observation are 27. As I already mentioned, 27. So 27 minus 1. Basically, this is n minus 1. N minus 1. So 27 minus 1 is 26. And if you add all this, it will also be 26. So between subject. So this is our between subject, which is 44.22. Between students, which is 44.67, interaction, which we have already calculated, 56.44, and error within, which we have already calculated, 182.67, mean square. So now you need to divide 44.22 divided by 2, which is 22.11, 44.67 divided by 2, which is 22.335, and 56.44 divided by 4, 14.11, and 182.67 divided by 18, which is 10.143. Now we need to calculate 3F ratios. Why? Because one for this, and one for this. So how we will calculate F1? This is now between subject mean square error and divided by error sum of square. So this divided by this. So 22.11 divided by 10, it will be 2.17. Now for the second, between students, so this is in column, so this was the row and this is now the column mean square error. So 22.335 divided by 10, which is 2.20. And this one, so this is for the interaction. So interaction mean sum of square divided by error sum of square. So 14.11 divided by 10.14833. So when you calculate this, the fifth step is the critical region. So for F1 is 2.17, and for F1 degree of freedom will be 2 and 18. Now we want to calculate this for 0.05, 2 and 18. Numerator degree of freedom, which is between subject mean square error divided by error sum of square. So this is 2 divided by error. So the error degree of freedom is 18. So we will find out this value from the table 2. And 18, 2 is the numerator, 18 is the denominator. So I am going to the table to show. So you can see this is our 0.05, numerator degree of freedom is 2 and denominator degree of freedom is 18. So for 2 and this is 18, which is 3.55. So you can see this is our 3.55. So where is your 2.17 line? 2.17 line in the accepted region. So accept H naught. Okay. Similarly, for the second degree of freedom, so this is between column mean sum of square. So the degree of freedom for column for the student is 2 and divided with error 18. So you once again you need to have a 0.0. So we have already calculated 3.55 and 2.20 is still lying in the accepted region. So therefore we also accept the second our null hypothesis. Similarly, for the third one, the degree of freedom is 4 and divided the ratio of degree of freedom is the error sum of square degree of freedom is 18. So 4 to 18. So once again, I am going to the table in order to calculate degree of freedom for this. So you can see this is our numerator degree of freedom, which is 4. So 4 and 18. So this is 2.93. So this is 2.93. I have just written at this place 2.93. So 1.93 lying in the accepted region. So we also accept our third null hypothesis. So from this experiment, we concluded that all the null hypotheses are accepted. This one is also accepted. The second one is also accepted and the third one is also accepted. And we also include interaction. We also conduct an interactive analysis with replication. So I hope that you understand this. In my next lecture, I will show you that how you will conduct two-way ANOVA with interaction or with replication while using Microsoft Excel.